best friend too.
By my troth, I was seeking for a ball when I found you.
He's drowned in the brook. Look my inn, I used to see him.
There, I shall see my own figure.
Which I tend to be either a fool or a cipher.
I will tarry no longer with you. Farewell, Senor Love.
I'm glad of your departure. Adieu, good Monsieur Melancholy.
Love is merely a madness.
you have a cure in itself?
Yes. Why? And in this manner, he was to imagine me his love, his mistress, at which time being would I, but a moonish youth, grieve, the effeminate, apish, shallow, longing and liking, fantastical, inconstant, full of tears, full of smiles, for every passion softened, and for no passion truly anything. Would now like him, now loathe him, would entertain him, now forswear him, would weep for him, now spit at him, that I drag my suitor from his mad humor of love to a living humor of madness.
I will not be cured, you.
I would cure you if you would but call me Rosaline and come to my cove every day to woo me.
When I beg of my love, I will. Tell me where it is.
Go with me to it, and I'll show it you. By the way, you shall tell me where in the forest you live.
With all my heart for you.
Nay, you must call me Rosaline. Will you go, sister?
Thank you.
sure and better humble. The eyes, now the frills and softens. So shut their power gates on all emissions become tyrants, virtuous, murderers. And now I'm wrong in all my heart. And if my eyes can wound, now that them kill me. Now cannot be a spoon now. Why now, but now? Or thou canst not. Oh, for shame, for shame. Lie not to say my eyes are murderers. Now show the wound my eye has made in thee. Scratch thee, but with the pin, and there remains a scar of it.
Proud man. The best in the head of his time.
cheese. What's just the difference between the toaster rat and mango bananas? Now I'm in a very tiny manner, and that should be it without Sylvia's.
Phoebe, with all my heart.
I'll make it straight. Manners in my head and in my heart. I'll be bigger with him and pass him short. Go with me, Sylvia. Go.
Happiness, dear Rosalind.
Why, how now, Orlando? You, a lover, and you serve me such another trick. Never come in my sight more.
But my fair Rosalind, I come within an hour of my promise.
Break an hour's promise in love.
Pardon me, dear Rosalind.
Nay, and you be so tardy. I had at least been wooed of a snail.
Of a snail?
Hey, of a snail! For though he comes slowly, he carries his house in his head. A better jointure, I think, than you make a woman. Besides, he carries his destiny with